Hey, hi, hello. So in today's video we are gonna be talking about recipes. So search a comfy place to be and let's get right into it. This is the tortilla wrap that was trending back to 2020, and in my opinion this trend needs to be bring back. The famous feta pasta, but like a mac and cheese version. To be honest, I want to try that pasta so bad.
Let's make baked feta pasta mac and cheese, and let's make it spanakopita style. Add 2 blocks of feta to the center of a casserole dish. Then pour in 1 pound of dry macaroni or your small pasta of choice, along with 4 cups of half and half and 2 cups of water. Add a nice size sprinkle of kosher salt, then give it a little bit of a stir. Next, drizzle your feta with some extra virgin olive oil and crack some fresh black pepper over top. Then pop in a 350 degree oven for 30 minutes. When it comes out, you know the drill. Break up the feta and start mixing everything together. I only added 4 cups of liquid before I put it in the oven, and I needed to add more, so that's why I told you to add 6. Add 2 cups of Parmesan cheese now, or you can add it at the beginning phase as well. Give that a stir, then add a bunch of spinach. You can add fresh or frozen, just make sure frozen is well drained and warmed up. Next, add your phyllo dough topping. I will show you how to do this in another video. Then just break in and enjoy. Where else can I take this trend?
This guy is gonna teach us how to make a 15 minutes garlic bread. It was really interesting to watch.
Frozen garlic bread? How about 15 minute garlic bread?
Medium bowl. 1 cup of salted butter, soften.
1/4 cup fresh chopped parsley.
4 cloves of garlic.
Crush them all.
Mince.
And 1/2 cup of Parmigiano. Mix together till it looks like this. Ciabatta. Cut in half lengthwise. Take half your butter and just spread it all over.
Don't they just look beautiful?
Baking sheet, garlic bread on.
Into the oven, 400.
For about 10 minutes.
Take it out.
Oh my lord.
Oh, le petit croissant.
Oh my lord, I'm about to bust. A little bit of flaky salt, black pepper.
She's just right.
And juicy.
In this one, we are going to see how to make a delicious ramen. It looked difficult, I'm not gonna lie, but I think all the effort is worth it.
Let's do some cooking.
It's like a ASMR video. Also, the chicken that he made was out of this world, and I want to try it. This is like a volcano chocolate cake or just a chocolate cake. I really don't know. I just think that cake looked delicious. Video have two parts and I put both of them, so please don't come at me in the comments. This guy makes some birria tacos that were just out of this world. I just want to try them so bad.
We've been seeing these tacos everywhere, so today I'm going to show you guys how to make them. You're going to start out with some good cuts of beef. I'm using beef chuck, aka the shoulder, seasoned with salt and pepper, and give them a sear for about 30 seconds aside just to add a little bit of color, which is going to add flavor for later. Take them out, chop up an onion, 5 cloves of garlic, go in with those, the same pot. You're going to go in equal parts of beef stock and water, bring those to a simmer. Go in with some dried chili peppers. I use 2 here. Go in with some wet chipotle peppers as well. This is gonna add a delicious smoky flavor. And then you're gonna go in with some crushed tomatoes. Season with bay leaves, salt, cumin, Mexican oregano, and some lime juice. Throw all your meat back in there. And an hour later, you're gonna take all the other solids out. We're talking the peppers, the onions, the garlic. Throw them all into a blender. Blend them up into a nice puree. Pour that back into the pot, and you're gonna have to let that simmer for about 3 hours. In 3 hours, I'll have the final product. Come back. Let's put together some delicious birria tacos. My meat's been cooking for about 3 hours now. This is part 2. If you wanna learn how to make the meat, go to part 1 first. Take the meat out, shred it up with a couple forks. It literally falls apart like nothing. It's so tender, so juicy. Once you do that, you can start assembling the tacos. You're gonna grab some tortillas. I'm using corn tortillas. You can use flour, whatever you wanna do. Dip it in that consomme, throw it on a pan, go on with your cheese, go on with your meat, however much you want to use, and then you can go on some chopped onion and cilantro if you'd like. Flip it over like this, pat it down, and fry for about 3 minutes aside so that it gets crispy on the outside. They come out looking like this. These things are absolutely worth the hype. I've been seeing them everywhere and I knew I had to try them. I assumed you guys all did too. Serve with some consomme on the side, dip it in just like that, and let me tell you, these things are the juiciest tacos I've ever had in my whole life.
So that's all for today. If you like this video, you can subscribe and leave a comment down below. Bye.